Hello, MSA. Hello, AISTS. Before I begin, thank you very much for giving me this chance to talk about my experiences in entrepreneurship. And I hope what I share today helps all of you to take the plunge someday. Before I start, a quick intro about myself. I've been a basketball player. I've played basketball for the country at the Asian Championship, and after which did 4 years at IMG, working across multiple professional sports events, example, the ATP Tour, the PGA Tour, fashion events, individual athlete representations, etc., etc. After my experience at IMG, I always wanted to arm myself with a professional sports degree, and after multiple years of research, I came across the MSA program by the AISTS, which even today I attest that is the best in terms of sports knowledge that any program can deliver. After the program in 2008, I was lucky enough to be selected to be the sports manager of an international federation. In November 2007, I started my stint as the sports manager at the International Boxing Association. For me, after multiple years in professional sport, the experiences at IBA with amateur sport, with the Olympic family, the Olympic movement, gave me a 360 degree view of sport. First, as an athlete myself, then in terms of the economics of sport through professional sport, and later in terms of the Olympic ideals when it comes to the highest platform of sporting achievements. Having finished the Olympic Games, the World Cup, the World Championships at IBA, I came to the crossroads. I had to decide whether I continue for another Olympic cycle or take the chance to come back to India and set up a sports firm of my own. On this topic, I would like to tell you, all budding entrepreneurs, you need to ask yourself, do you have the conviction, the drive to go against conventional advice and follow your dream? And again, on this particular topic, I would like to share with all of you the most important question you need to ask yourself before you launch your firm or your product in a new market is, do you understand the social pulse of the market? Will your product, will your service be accepted in the market? And above the product itself, about pricing, about placement, the most important from my experience is timing. When is the right time to enter the market? And for me, just before the 2010 Commonwealth Games, it was the best. So having decided to come back to India, in June 2009, I find myself back in India, exploring the market, meeting different stakeholders to identify the best value proposition for sport. In one such meeting, I happened to meet my ex-principal from my own school, and he proposed that I take over the sports program at that school and control the quality and experience of sport in my own school. This was the birth of the Balanced Report Card Sports and Fitness program today. Armed with my first client, I went about hiring coaches, devising a curriculum that could be implemented across the year, and started work. And over the last 2 years, I've discovered that the program can be bettered by adding a module of infrastructure, by providing the infrastructure to the school also. All again, to top that, I realized if I added an aspirational value to sport by including the best names in sport to endorse and be part of this initiative, the product could be scaled up to many more schools. Today, SportsMentor is owned by two of India's most iconic sportspersons, Sachin Tendulkar, Virendra Sehwag. And as partners, we have Sports Mechanics, who has been at the pinnacle of performance analysis for Indian teams at international competitions. And to top it all, we also have the AISTS as our coaches training and academic partner. Today, SportsMentor offers a school multiple benefits. We offer a school sports infrastructure. We offer a school sports instructors. We offer the school the overall quality management of the sports program across the year. With all this, today, SportsMentor has also been mandated to run the national championship for 8 sports across the country. This puts us in direct connection with the sporting future of India across the next 5 years. And with this effort, we aim to someday create a better performance or result in a better performance at the Youth Olympic Games and the Olympic Games.
Indian team started that, and then after that, there are 22 other teams in the world who've ended up using their expertise with the new venture to give this opportunity to children. Being a parent, I know how important it is to provide the right platform for all the children to express their talent. On various occasions, it goes unnoticed because they don't have proper playgrounds, and just the short film which showed there were not many guys playing on concrete surface, and then all of a sudden the same spot looked different because there was beautiful AstroTurf where you could play hockey, football, cricket.
I think SportsMentor developed a curriculum for sports, especially for school kids, which I'm using in my school, Sabah International School. And the curriculum is comprehensive, is giving benefit to the kids. Kids are getting a benefit from that curriculum because they're enjoying the sports and they're learning the sports skills through that curriculum. Important thing is to develop a kid character, to develop a kid's his own thinking. I think that comes through sports. And if any school using this curriculum, I'm sure that they will get the benefit from this curriculum because I'm using, and it's worth it. So I'm asking all of you guys to use the curriculum in your school.
SportsMentor has started its work in the grassroots level, that is the school level, from where we can train the students as they come up. Their approach, I really appreciate. So I wish all the best for the SportsMentor with the view of improving the sports and games in our country.
When we came across the balanced report card program of SportsMentor, we found that they share the same thought. And they look into the science and sports, where we teach sports, the science through sports. Recently, we had a vivacious football tournament for students of 4.5 to 5.5 year age. In fact, this is our flagship program. This is into Limca Book of Records because we are first in the country and fourth in the world to have such a unique program for 4.5 to 5.5 year old kids. And the SportsMentor, as the co-event organizers, have done a fantastic job.
Amazing event, nothing less than watching in FIFA or UEFA Cup.
I think it's a great thing. I've never seen something like this arranged by a school. I mean, you know, it is something which we are doing a revolution.
I think this is the platform all the like kids, and they will get the knowledge of how to play everything, games and all.
And I'm extremely happy with SportsMentor for standing as a supporter in this event.
The AISTS and our founding partners, the International Olympic Committee, the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology, the Universities of Lausanne and Geneva, the IMD Business School, are thrilled to be part of SportsMentor and its mission to transform the sports experience for students in India.
The Balanced Report Card program assured me that along with doing well in my academics, I can take up a sport and really excel in that. And now I'm going to the US for a brighter future. But because of the Balanced Report Card program, within a short span of 4 months, now I have a confirmed seat in the university and with a full scholarship. What more do I need to say?
What did I learn over the last 3 years of conceptualizing the sports mentor schemes in the country? The business plan. Allow yourself at least 1 year before you crystallize your efforts into a business plan. Your product will need a minimum of 1 year to settle down and gain acceptance in the market. Costs will change, demand will change, product configuration will change. So do not start or aim to start your venture by formulating a business plan at the very beginning. Start, allow yourself 1 year to settle down, and after which, please crystallize your plans for the future, for the 3 years or 5 years, into a business plan. How do you hire? What are the main principles? Make sure you do every job yourself before you look for support to do the same. When you hire for a particular responsibility, make sure you hire somebody who can do the job better than you. Allow for mistakes. Make sure in the initial phases you allow maximum room for mistakes, because in the long run, your team will be better off and stronger to handle the bigger challenges of scaling up and expanding geographically. Value creation. Once your business has settled down, your product has been accepted, your cash flow has stabilized, you will have to ask yourself, is it time to expand? Is it time to scale up? And at this juncture, you will have to ask yourself, do I want to be a big fish in a small pond or a small fish in a big pond? By this, what do I mean? You need to know the biggest return of investment monetarily will accrue when you divest ownership stake or stake in your concern. It is not comparable to operational profit. And if you choose to scale up by divesting stake in your firm, you need to make sure who that target investor could be. My recommendation: sport as a business will always be driven by passion than monetary return of investment. So for your first round of fundraising, I recommend go with somebody who shares the same passion about sport with you. Do not latch on to an investor who is looking at making money using your business proposition. Leave that to the second or third round of fundraising. Sustaining your business model. Once you have your investors lined up, once you have your business plan chalked out, it's very important that you set in motion processes that could replace personnel along the way. You need to ensure that the organization is stronger than an individual. Point two, you need to ensure that the company and the processes will continue without the founders. The partnership with the AISTS. Even during the program in Lausanne, during my MSA days, I knew without a doubt that the spectrum of sports sciences that the AISTS and the MSA program deals with the array of sports professionals from across the world that the MSA program brings to the class cannot be beaten in any manner. So when it came to identifying an international partner for Sports Mentor's business for the Indian market, the AISTS was my first choice. And over the last 2 years, the AISTS has not only helped me in terms of quality resources to help join Sports Mentor, they have consistently delivered in terms of any requirement, that any connections that we needed for the Indian market from its network across the world. So my recommendation to all you candidates of the MSA program for the year: try for a job at the IOC, try for a job at an established international federation, try for a job at a professional agency in sport. But if you get a chance, if you have a small desire to start your own firm in sport in your own country, take it as early as possible. With the AISTS network, with the MSA network, you can connect and meet any requirement when it comes to sport in your market. By doing this, someday the MSA network across the world could be the most powerful collection of sports professionals meeting different needs in different markets across the world. On this note, thank you for this chance to talk to all of you, and look forward to seeing all of you someday somewhere in the world. Thank you very much.